Haripreet sir, did you get the invite?
Yeah, sir.
Very good. Everything fine?
Yeah, everything fine, sir.
We'll wait 1 minute, 1 or 2 minutes, if others join.
Yeah, no problem, sir.
Only Cochin people have joined. Do you see the screen?
Aye, sir.
Full screen?
Yeah, not full screen, sir.
This is full screen only.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, let us start. I think yes. Okay, let us start. This is the 25th presentation of the course on CO22 chemicals and fuels. So I must thank all the participants for the continued support. In this thing, we are going to project certain things which are not available in the literature. That is why I said it is an important thing. Okay. Before that, this being a concluding presentation on this topic, and NCR wishes all the participants all success on their research endeavors. And NCCR also hopes that it's made an attempt to reach the research scholars of this country, possibly yielded some semblance of result. We will see whether it is true or not in the little later. I will make an analysis of who participated, how it has come out, and all those things. Now, the purpose of this presentation is one. One is very obvious, that we wanted to test online course by NCCR, whether we will be able to do it instead of every time bringing people. We will continue that, but still, in addition to continuing the orientation program, we wanted to see whether we will be able to keep all of you in contact so that it is possible to run a few courses, few specialized courses, few frontier area courses by NCCR. So this is one of them. As you know, CO2 to chemicals and fuels is not a finished area. We are going to look at all those things a little later. Even though there is some kind of a indications that it may be a successful process, but today it is not a successful process. So therefore, successful process means a commercially viable process. So it may yield the but we are only preparing ourselves. When it yields a commercially viable process, we must be able to take over that. That is the one thing. Second objective of this course is to assess, because CO2 to chemicals and fuels is a very important frontier area in which we have not discussed many other aspects. We will see what are the aspects we have not discussed. The reason being that as a chemist or a chemical engineer, we are only interested in converting the molecule to the value-added products. So therefore, we are only assessing those aspects. There are meaningful ways of harnessing or capturing and all those things. That is, we are not going to be dealing with those things. They are also possible. Even biologists, agriculturists, or all of them are also interested in CO2 chemistry. Now, another thing that we have been trying to do is, as I told you, this is an evolving field. Every hour, the subject is changing over. So therefore, is it possible to assimilate all these things in a meaningful manner, in spite of the fact that it can be going on growing in the field? That is what we have tried to do this time. Okay, we do not know whether we have succeeded it or not, but it is up to you to decide. Simultaneously, we wanted to summarize. Okay, summarize means, what is it that it holds us in from making this process a viable process? We have indicated few of them. We are going to indicate few more today, and you will understand. And finally, after all, we are doing a science topic. Therefore, it should instill some interest, some excitement in people who are listening to this. That is the reason that we have tried to give this course. Okay, and you will be surprised to know that we have given this course for the past 4 months. We started on February 11th. Today we are for the similar situation in May. So therefore, February, March, April, May. So 4 months we have continuously done this. So that itself is a success. 4 months we could survive with all of you online. So that itself is a very good thing. Now what we have done, okay, what we should have done is different from what we have done. Okay, we have tried to review the literature in this area in a fashion that is understandable to us, not as it is reviewed in the literature. Okay, for example, I have given one of the very important things that I have given here is, in the photocatalytic reduction of carbon dioxide, the major issue is the analysis of the products. That is the crux of the thing. We are going to look at it today, some other time. Okay, we are only hoping for GC analysis without understanding that there can be interference in the GC analysis. Not only GC analysis, any analysis, spectrophotometric analysis or HPLC or mass spec, all of them will have the interference effect, which we have pointed out, but we have none of us have realized this. So this is one of them that we have pointed out as the lacuna that is available in the literature. Another thing that we have been repeatedly pointing out about the photocatalytic reduction of CO2 is the measure. How will I identify the activity? In what units that we will identify the activity? It is going to be based upon catalyst, or is it based upon illumination? So, or is it going to be based upon both? These are the issues that we have raised. To identify the issues where knowledge is not yet complete and why this process is not feasible today. Feasible means commercially, okay? You should not think that it is not feasible. It is feasible, but we are only getting some micromoles. Now, what we have tried in this 25 presentations is to outline the issues where the further knowledge domain has to be evolved. Just now I told you two of them. Some more things that we are going to see. One is the measure, another one is the analysis. That is not the only thing. Even the materials is a problem here. how to look at a new material, because we are in the photocatalytic reduction of CO2 or even in the electrocatalytic reduction of CO2, we are only going on the traditional parts. Okay, we are going to ask a very valid question. Is it not the time for us to get away from the titanium dioxide for the photocatalytic reduction? Just to give an example. So therefore, such questions we have to ask. So therefore, that is the reason to outline the issues where further knowledge domain has to be evolved. To evolve an online complete course for NCCR on a frontier topic. This is an experiment we did. We are going to look at few more frontier topics in the coming months. Okay, depending upon how many of you are interested and what topics you will be interested in. Then we hope we have done this, but I do not know whether you have already seen. If you have all the 25 presentations, you will be surprised. We have assembled all the 25 presentations in the hard copy form, and we saw that it is a tremendous documentation on this topic. So these are all the things that we have achieved in this program. Okay, that is what the NCCR is claiming, but it is not clear for us whether we have achieved all of them. For you it is to decide. Okay, now if I were to take the CO2 reduction, I will take you a few minutes. CO2 reduction and the water decomposition, these are the two reactions that we are worried about. Now if you look at it from the heat of formation of the free energy of formation of CO2 and water, CO2 is more stable, about 100 kilojoules more stable than water. So therefore, water decomposition should be facile compared to CO2 reduction or CO2 to chemicals. That is the first thing. Second thing is, water decomposition involves a limited number of electrons. Only one single product of hydrogen and oxygen are produced. Whereas in the case of the CO2, a tremendous amount of products are formed: methane, methanol, ethane, ethanol, acetaldehyde, formaldehyde, many products. In addition to that, water, there is no difficulty in number of water molecules being present. Whereas CO2, when we are taking it in a solution phase, the solubility of CO2, all these things we have indicated, the numbers we have given. So therefore, that we are not going to do that, but we are only going to this only to show you what is the difficulty in this process. The solubility of CO2 is very small. We have already given the numbers, okay, 0.033 moles. Many products are formed. So we have, most of the time we have only looked at the liquid phase reaction, but we have not talked about much about the gas phase reaction. It is also possible to do this. Then the mechanism involves tremendous number of electrons and protons. We are going to look at them here. Okay, so therefore this means that the catalysts that are employed, the co-catalysts that are employed, must be capable of generating this proton and the electron. So we have to look at from that point of view. Now the products that are formed also can undergo decomposition on the photocatalyst that we are used. This is one aspect that we have not done, but we have to realize that. So therefore, in order to overcome this, we have to use, instead of stationary state reactors, we have to use a continuous flow reactors. Thermodynamically, water production from water, hydrogen production from water is a more feasible process, and CO2 reduction is a less probable, less favorable reaction. Okay, we will be seeing little later what is all these things meaning. Okay, we are looking at the reduction potential of the electrons. We will come to it little later. In view of the last vast literature, the course attempted only a tiny portion of this area. Only CO2 reduction only we took. As I told you initially itself, there are many other aspects on the CO2 chemistry which we have not done. Okay, and we are not going to attempt to them. Okay, even here we have concentrated on three or four main areas: chemical reduction, electrochemical reduction, photocatalytic reduction, and biochemical reaction. It attempted to look at the status of the CO2 to chemicals and fuels. That is all what is in this, also restricted to chemical, electrochemical, photocatalytic, and to small extent biochemical methods. That is what we did. Okay, general questions. Okay, before we go to your specific questions, general question is there promise to make this process viable? Many of the statements or many of the conclusions in the many of the reviews which I have given already, and there are many more reviews, maybe you will be able to learn many of them. Many of these reviews finally gives the impression that it is possible to make this process viable. Okay, I will read one statement from a review from Angwan Takemi in the 2012 review, 2012 review or 2013 review, 2013 review. The final statement is, however, with the current phase of development in this field, the emerging understanding of the mechanism as well as novel materials should bring the promise held by the process much closer to fulfillment in the near future. That is the similar conclusion is drawn by many of them. Is it true? Is the question. Now, chemical process that we have done already. So, therefore, what is the situation? Is the question. How and what stage are they? Okay. Have they reached the commercial production point of view? Many process we have already talked about it. Few of them, but few of them are only in the early stages. Electrochemical pathway, we have only looked at the metals. Okay, even in the metals we have taken only a four groups. What we have done is, if either in the point, from the point of view of hydrogen overwhelming potential is high or low, or from the point of view of chemistry option is strong or weak, from these points of view, or the hydrocarbon formation or carbon monoxide formation, which is the best. That is all what we have looked in the electrochemical pathway. But we have not looked into other electrodes. We have briefly touched about the semiconductor electrodes, but we have not done extensively on semiconductor electrodes. So therefore, this is one area which we have to, at a later stage, look at what will happen. Is a question. How to go about making electrochemical pathway a feasible and viable process? That is the next question. These are all general questions. Photocatalytic or hybrid process, which one and why? Okay, photocatalytic is already known. Hybrid process we have already seen. Which one we have to choose and why? Okay, the situation appears to be the hybrid process may be more because the amount of the product formed is already about hundreds of micromoles, whereas in the photocatalytic mode it is 1 to 10 micromoles only. So that is the problem that is existing. Biochemical process, what is it that we have learned? Is that we have learned a basic lesson how the electron transfer has to take place in a very stepwise manner so that the redox potential of the species can be suitably altered. We will take it up a little later. This I have repeatedly told, that the redox potential of the electron must be like an escalator. It should be going on changing with respect to time, so that conveniently at the convenient point there will be an exchange of the electrons. So this is what we are facing. Some specific questions. Okay, one, we have already talked about this, is the analytical methods, are they appropriate? If they are not appropriate, how are we going to make them appropriate? That is the question we have to answer, because before we answer this, we will not be able to take up the CO2 to a logical conclusion. Energetics, I have already talked about it, that energetically CO2 reduction is a less favorable reaction compared to water decomposition reaction. Even water decomposition reaction itself is not successful. So for CO2 reduction cannot be successful at this point of time. But energetics wise, biochemically we have seen that it is a feasible process. So therefore, energetically it is a feasible process, even though it is a difficult process. What is lacking for us is that we are not having suitable redox species which can be transferring the species in a cyclic manner, so that they transfer, they undergo reduction, then subsequent steps they will undergo oxidation. So this is another problem that is existing that we have to clearly follow that. The third question, okay, which we have repeatedly told is the quantitative measure. We have been told, telling you that we will give you one or two measures other than the measures that we have per gram, per hour, or per elimination, or whatever it is. Okay, all of them are some kind of a formal quantum efficiency, FQE. Okay, formal quantum efficiency, like a formal potential. Okay, formal potential is not the standard potential, like that. I will later on talk to, when we talk about electrochemistry, we will talk about what is formal potential and what is standard potential. Okay, but we should understand this, because we are, most of the time we are only talking about formal potentials and using the standard potential. At the same way, this formal quantum efficiency is only a formal value. It is not the true measure of the reactivity of the catalyst system. Then we have not talked about what is the formulation guidelines for the suitable catalyst that we are going to draw. We have only talked about p-type semiconductor, n-type semiconductor, redox potential, conduction bandage, like that, with some specific parameters, but we have not talked about giving guidelines. Okay, guidelines means, one guideline we have already talked about it, D0 configuration and D10 configuration. But we saw the D0, D10 alone is not enough to show that this is possible. This is a recapitulation of what we have been talking about water catalysis. So I'm not going to repeat this again and again, but you can see that when we do a photocatalyst, the reason why I'm putting it, we are going to give some guidelines for photocatalyst formulation. So we must know what we are trying to do is, we are trying to suppress the surface recombination, volume recombination, both of them must be reduced. At the same time, the surface reduction and the surface oxidation must be done. Now, where is the lacuna? Okay, I wanted to project a slide for that, but I have forgotten to do that. But anyway, it doesn't matter. Suppose if I have a semiconductor which absorbs, on which I am shining 100 photons, you will be surprised to know that only 6 or 5 photons are essentially used for the conversion of the surface reaction. Remaining 92, 93, 95 photons are utilized in various processes. Either it is scattered or it is recombined, many things. Okay, maybe some other time, or I will say, send you a package of PowerPoints where you can see all these numbers being given. So therefore, just a minute.
சரி 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 பார்க்கலாம் என்ன நடக்குதுன்னு பார்க்கலாம் சரி ஓகே இல்ல இப்ப ஊர்ல இல்ல வாங்க வெளியில போயிருக்கான் நான் இந்த வாரம் தான் பண்ணுவான்னு நினைக்கிறேன் இந்த வார கடைசியில தான் பண்ணுவான் அவன் எங்க புளாரிடா போயிருக்கான் அவன் அவன் இவ போகும்போது வந்துருவான் அவன் அங்க பாஸ்டனுக்கு வந்துருவான் அதுக்கு போவானான்னு தெரியல எனக்கு ஏன்னா புளாரிடால இருக்கான் இன்னைக்கு நான் ரெண்டு நாளைக்கு முன்னாடி தான் பேசினேன் நான் வேணா இன்னைக்கு இங்கே சாயங்காலம் பேசினா கேட்குறேன் ஹாரோஸ்கோப்பு ஆ தெரியும் ஆ சரி சரி கொடுங்க
பாய் சாரி தேர் வாஸ் எ ஃபோன் கால் ஓகே ப்ளீஸ் எக்ஸ்கியூஸ் மீ ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த ப்ராப்ளம் தட் த ஃபோட்டான் 100 ஃபோட்டான்ஸ் இஃப் யூ புட் ஓன்லி 6 or 7 ஃபோட்டான்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் ஸோ ஹியர் ஐ எம் கிவிங் யூ வெரி வெரி ரீசன்ட் பேப்பர் விச் ஐ எம் சாரி யூ கேன் நாட் கோட் இட் பிகாஸ் இட் இஸ் நாட் இட் சீன் த பப்ளிகேஷன் த they have come up with another formal quantum efficiency F to QE in terms of moles formed per photon. This is one another attempt to normalize in terms of illumination. Okay, now I do not know whether you have seen this picture. This picture I showed it in the biochemical active biochemical pathway of CO2 reduction. The message that we have given here is that CO2 can be activated only if I have sites in such a way the CO2 bond angle can come very near to the tetrahedral angle. Okay, so this must be very clear, and this reference is already there. I hope you are able to see, and this projection I have already shown it to you many other times, therefore the reference will be there. Now coming to the analysis point of view, okay, we have been only talking about analysis, but we have not talked about what are the lacuna in the analysis. One issue is, major issue is the interference. Okay, for example, I will tell you, it will be very easily understandable to you. If I have two organic molecules, they can also couple with each other. Okay, so therefore the coupling reaction is a well-known reaction in organic chemistry. So when I inject a reaction mixture which is containing multiple functional groups like aldehyde, alcohol and all those things, they will be able to interact among themselves. Therefore, by simply looking at the peak area and a gas chromatograph does not give us the quantitatively the amount of the product that is formed, because they are coupling with each other. Okay, so therefore the analysis of the products, if at this stage if you look at it, it should be done at least in two different ways, and if both agree, then only we can understand that there is certain amount of confidence level. That doesn't mean that it is the absolute level, it is only confidence level increasing, absolute magnitude is not increasing. We have already talked about this appropriate analytical method. Okay, I'm not going to talk about it again, but as I told you, each of the product has to be analyzed in more than one way, in the photocatalytic reduction of CO2 or in any other method of reduction of CO2. So therefore we have to evolve appropriate analytical method for the analysis of the products. Okay, so we will leave it at that stage, this issue, but this issue must be resolved at least for in a research team that it is necessary. The second issue is, which we have just now talked, is how to do the electrode materials. Okay, very very grossly we have done it as four group metals. We are not going to repeat it in terms of hydrogen over voltage, oxygen over CO chemisorption, all those possibilities we have taken, but it is, we have not thought about what will happen if I were to generate new composite electrodes. This is one area which is left out. Okay, because why we are looking at it is, you take the photocatalytic decomposition of water. Photocatalytic decomposition of water is not done on metals, it is done only on semiconductors. Maybe slightly it is done on insulators, but the efficiency is less, therefore we are looking at the semiconductors. So in the same way, we have to look at the CO2 reduction on composite electrodes and not on metallic electrodes. Electrocatalytic reduction is the thing. Okay, there appears to be some scope for more studies on this system by electrochemical means. That we have not yet reached that stage, but we must do this. So this will be one of the areas of research that has to be done before the Western world comes up with new things. The purpose of this is to, purpose of this course itself is to bring the best the frontier knowledge, so that we will be able to overcome the inhibitions that we have. The inhibitions that we have is, I will tell you the inhibition. For example, in the case of the photocatalytic reaction, the many of the Western world is looking at the titanium dioxide. Therefore, we are also looking at titanium dioxide. So this is not a good solution. if we want to go ahead with ahead means that we were to be innovative, we have to be thinking independent of the other results that are available. That doesn't mean those results cannot be utilized. Those results can be utilized, can be assimilated, can be formulated, can be designed for the new systems. But that doesn't mean that we should use that path. We will come back to this question little later. So now what we, the chemical process, the presentation was based on specific products. For example, we talked about the some urea derivatives and that thing. Okay. Now we have not looked at the alternate ways of synthesis of these products and how that knowledge can be put here in the reduction, chemical reduction of the CO2. That we have not done, and this is not done in the literature. This has to be very clearly done. Okay. What is the future of the chemical routes for CO2 reduction? Are they going to be only based upon the products or the process? Okay, that is what we have to decide. We feel up to now it was always based upon the product, but it should be based upon the process. Whether the process is less energy intensive, more energy intensive, that is the question that we have to ask, rather than whether I get a particular product or not. Okay. Now this projection is a collection of all the things that we have put. Okay. I will take this in a simplified manner. This is the summary of the photocatalytic reaction. I hope you are able to see here all the semiconductors that we have to. Therefore, CO2 anion radical is nearly 1.9 volts. So you can see that none of the semiconductors are capable of giving that, except cuprous oxide is very near to that. The conduction band minimum is suitable for that. All other things, therefore, I will come to it in a minute. Okay. So therefore, what we are trying to do when we are sensitizing a semiconductor, what we are doing? Okay. There are varieties of ways of sensitizing. No doping, metal ion, metal doping, nitrogen doping, oxygen vacancies, sensitizing with a dye, sensitizing with a semiconductor, sensitizing with a molecule, ruthenium bipyridyl complex. Many ways we are sensitizing. Okay, all these things. If you look at this picture at the bottom, we have shown you. The sodium tantalate and silver tantalate, and the same way sodium niobate and silver niobate. What we have done, you can see very clearly that the conduction band edge is not altered because that is contributed by the tantalum 5D or niobium 4D. The silver only adjusts the valence band. Okay, I hope you are able to see. That is why what you have done is you have done a band gap engineering. But what we have to clearly, please listen here carefully, what we have to look at the semiconductor is how will I alter the position of the conduction band, because the position of the conduction band is far different from the reduction potential of CO2 to CO2 anion radical. So therefore, all the attempts that we have done, because the conduction band is contributed by the cation. And since we are not doing anything to the cation, we are not doing anything to the position of the conduction band minimum. We are only altering this valence band maximum. We have already answered this question. I am repeating that point here because this is not yet realized. Now you remember that in the photocatalytic reactions, we are only worried about the removal of the pollutant. Removal of the pollutant means we are oxidizing that. So the oxidizing power is controlled by the valence band. So if the valence band is sufficiently more positive with respect to the oxidation potential of this pollutant, it will do. And that is what is happening in titanium dioxide. So therefore, in the titanium dioxide, the valence band is sufficiently more positive with respect to the pollutant oxidation potential. And therefore, see, titanium dioxide is a very good polluter. Substance which can photocatalytically remove the pollutants, but the conduction band is what is necessary for the reduction reaction. Okay, we have already shown all these 8 reactions, so I am not going to repeat that. 2 electrons, 4 electrons, 6 electrons, 8 electrons, etc., etc. And then what will happen, the nitrogen doping and all of them. So the questions, okay, I hope you understand the question here. The question here is, all our sensitization has been only, how will I be able to transfer the electron from the sensitizer to the conduction band? But what we need is, how will I change the position of the conduction band so that the reducing power of the semiconductor can be increased? This is what is the crux of the problem. So when we want to look for new semiconductors, we have to now forget about all these things about altering the valence band. Okay, yes, altering the valence band has a significance. For example, pollutant removal, maybe for oxygen evolution. Okay, it is, I hope you are able to see, in the case of the titanium dioxide, or even if you take titanium dioxide, this is the oxygen evolution potential. This is more positive with respect to oxygen reduction potential. So therefore, you can see, you take any semiconductor, most of the semiconductors, except a few of them, most of the semiconductors can be capable of effectively acting as a pollutant removal. So therefore, there is no new knowledge that is coming out of this pollutant. You are only maybe making a new process, but new knowledge, science knowledge is not there, because all of them are, the valence band position is more positive. For example, you take tin oxide, it is so beautifully positioned with respect to oxygen evolution reaction. So therefore, I will not repeat all of them again and again. So therefore, what is the crux of this problem is that we have devised all our methods only to modulate the band gap engineering. Sodium tantalate, 4 electron volts. Silver tantalate, 3.4 electron volts. Sodium niobate, 3.4 electron volts. Silver niobate, 2.8 electron volts. So you take the undoped niobate, the band gap is 3.5. Nitrogen doped niobate, 2.7. But the conduction band is not at all altered. But what we want is the conduction band has to be altered. Then only CO2 reduction can take place. So in our search for new catalytic systems, new photocatalytic system, we have to worry about this position of the conduction band. I will stop that issue for the present, because we have to go a little longer way. This is a very summarized slide for the biochemical route. What we are doing, okay, I hope you are able to understand. We are simply taking photosystem 1 and photosystem 2, putting the light there, then the proton is added on, so NADP, NADP, ADP, all those things are there, the CO2, then the phosphoglycerate route, acetyl CO rate, I hope you already know, this is a Calvin cycle, there are 6 cycles which we have already talked about it. All of them are involving some kind of a organic moiety getting incorporated into it and then regenerating it. So there are varieties of steps involved for example, phosphoglycerate, acetyl COA, all of them. Ultimately, you are synthesizing the reducer products. So now, quickly looking at what is the result of this, all these 25 presentations. One, some data on the online course. Total lifetime view of this is 6,662 views have happened so far. Okay, so therefore, average view per presentation appears to be 26, but it is not true. Every presentation might not have been viewed by 26 people. Totally 662 views have happened for this 25 presentations. In the last 1 month alone, this is from February to May, okay, 662 views. Last month alone, we had about 262 views, okay, of our site, the YouTube and other things, okay. It involves the online as well as offline. Now, how many minutes they have viewed this, last month alone, about 1,100 minutes they have viewed. So this gives us an idea about what is the level of popularity of this program. I am not going to comment anything on that, but I am just telling you. And you can see the demography of the people viewing this. Okay, totally about 28 countries have viewed it, but major views have been obviously it has to be India, because this has been designed only for India. Okay, it is, my whole aim itself is that the Indian scientist must overtake in this field at least. That is why I have taken this as the first exercise in this, even though I might not have succeeded in that. India, USA comes second, then the third position, Turkey and Egypt, they are more or less same, and then UK. So therefore you can see that it is not so unpopular. Okay, so now I am giving you a few ideas about some typical presentations. So therefore we are taking few presentations in the last month. Okay, April 14, April 18, April 20, 23, 28, May 1 and May 5. So I have given you, there I put an average number. Here I am giving you the actual views. For example, the April 14, 13 people have viewed, 112 minutes they have viewed. Okay, the minute of the presentation itself is given here, 34 minutes. Okay, so I hope you are able to see. This number here is the presentation time. This is the total viewing time by the others. The percentage composition is given. Okay, anyway, I'm not going to talk about it. So going back, okay, that is only an analysis of our presentation. So now I'm going to talk to you as I told you, the photocatalytic, at least one of the questions I wanted to answer. So therefore this picture I have adapted it from a journal, Aerosol and Air Quality Research, but this is not drawn very clearly, so I will take the next one where I got drawn by my own hand. I hope you are able to see. We will not worry about what is this semiconductor. Okay, let us assume that this the semiconductor is titanium dioxide only, I have shown here, but we will not worry about it. So now the position of the conduction band is minus 0.44 electron volts, the position of the valence band is minus 7.6, therefore the band gap is 3.2 electron volts. So now what is going to happen is the question. Now look at it, what is happening. Now let us assume that I have only one platinum atom put on this semiconductor, okay, and I have shown the CO2 gas. Directly I take the CO2 gas dissolved or in the gaseous phase, I want to put that electron. So now you see I can't do this. I can't easily do either from the directly from the semiconductor. I have not drawn here, but I have drawn here, I have shown here, either from the semiconductor or from the platinum cluster. This is platinum cluster. Okay, small particles. Okay, platinum small particles. This platinum, single platinum atom, this is the unoccupied level. These are the unoccupied levels of the platinum cluster. So now if platinum, on the platinum cluster CO2 are to be absorbed, then the reduction potential can be altered. I hope you are able to see. So what is the message here? Okay, now I have shown here platinum bulk. If I were to take this semiconductor, put platinum black, still it cannot reduce. Only if I were to put platinum in a small scale, in a cluster scale, that is, and if I were to make sure that CO2 is absorbed, then only it will be able to reduce. So the message here is, okay, when I want to use a co-catalyst, I have to see their energy positions. It is not enough if I see the energy positions, I must also see the adsorptive capacity of the co-catalyst. You should not immediately say platinum is the co-catalyst. Here it is taken as an example only. Okay, it can be anything else. So now I hope you are able to understand why the whole process is so difficult. So if I have to formulate something, then you have to be very careful that the species that you are talking about must be capable of getting adsorbed and capable of having free energy of the reaction in the negative sense, not in the positive sense here like this. Okay, so this is the I hope you have already seen this, so I will not do this. Here I have shown you two data. Okay, the blue one is the number of views for the month of April to May, May 8th, April 11th to May 8th, the number of views is given by graphical representation. The red one or the one shows the minutes, estimated minutes watched. I hope you are able to see that we are having some peaks at on the 5th May and in the, on the 29th of 28th of April and also on the 14th of April. So therefore, this shows you what is the situation. Quickly looking at it, okay, here I hope you have seen this reference. If you are not seen this reference, you must see this reference. Okay, this is a Philosophical Transactions at Royal Society 2010. What we are talking about it, we are taking CO2 and going from the green pathway to the fuels and taking the fuel in the red pathway come to the CO2. Now from the CO2 we can go to the syngas and then to the chemicals. From the syngas we can go to the chemicals, from the syngas we can go to the fuels. We have already talked about dry and tri reforming, so I will not talk about it again and again, but these are all new terminologies, new formulations. Okay, now all those things, the CO2 can also be reformed with biogas and all those things. We will not go into all of them. So the fuels, and then it can also, the biomass can also give rise to the sun can also go to the biomass and produce the fuels, and then we will be able to combust them, produce the CO2, then get it back. Okay, so this is the type of sites that are available. The same situation is given here in a different manner. We will not again repeat this this projection. I might have shown you from the CO2 and hydrogen, I want to CO and water. Okay, and then effectively I want to produce the hydrocarbons, store energy as hydrocarbons, transport energy as hydrocarbons, use hydrocarbons and liquid fuels. Hydrocarbons plus fire gives rise to CO2 and water. So net production of hydrogen, production of carbon dioxide will be zero if I were to reverse this process. So this is the sum and substance of it. This is this projection. I have shown it to you before, but to repeat it, to make the situation more clear, here I have shown the free energy of formation of water and CO2. That's all. We will not worry about it. The why I have shown all of them is these are the products that we are thinking of. Okay. These products are having lesser free energy of formation compared to this. So therefore, when I take CO2 and want to make methanol, take CO2 and want to make hydrocarbon or make methane, all of them are uphill task. Okay. Even if I take water and want to produce hydrogen, it is an uphill process. But this uphill is lesser than this uphill. I hope you are able to see. For example, you take CO2 to methane and see water to hydrogen. Definitely the appeal is more for the CO2 to methane. Okay, so this is the thing. Okay, this is another way of showing this. We will not go into all of them again. You electrolyze water, then take the CO2, put the methanol synthesis, CO2 plus hydrogen giving rise to methanol. Then from the methanol you can go give rise to the carbon dioxide, then CO2 from the atmosphere can be a thing. Okay, these are all can be done. Okay, now here spend 1 minute here. What I have tried to put, this is the paper from this paper. What we have tried here is to put all the products, all the semiconductors that we have used. Okay, in the x-axis the wavelength. Okay, the energy that I have to expand or they get the, from the solar radiation or any photons, and the y-axis is the quantum efficiency. Okay, so you can see the quantum efficiency is only 0.10%, not 100%. What we want is the question mark we have put here. I hope you are able to see. We want a semiconductor or a material that will be able to absorb in the visible region, okay, here above 400, and also give rise to quantum efficiencies above 10% but below 100%. So this is the dark region. What we are doing is we are looking at the 1, 2, 3. These three quadrants, but we are not looking at this quadrant. I hope you are taking the message. I will not repeat this message again. Okay. Finally, I will tell you that is it time to think other catalysts than TO2 for water splitting or CO2 reduction? This the second question that we are leaving with your mind is when we take the CO2, when we take titanium dioxide, this is a problem that is there which none of us have recognized. When we synthesize CO2 titanium dioxide, they are having certain kind of a shape evolution. Okay, it is evolving along the planes of 001. Okay, why this is happening? Because we have already seen these two planes are, one of them is active, another one is not active. So therefore we have to think about all these things. So at this point I will stop and then take 5 minutes to discuss with you directly, and then we will be able to continue the discussion without the projection, without the broadcast. Any questions, please? Because all of you are present today, so I am very happy to see all of you. So please tell me any questions. Hello, are you listening? Any one of you?
Hello,
Prakriti. Yes, sir. My friends at Bombay.
Hello. Hello, sir. Hello.
Yes, please.
Sir, actually, in last second slide, you shown that four quarters.
So, okay.
Means that four quarters you shown that.
Do you want me to repeat?
So, what?
I will show it again. Okay, I hope you are seeing. In the x-axis, I have used the energy scale. In the y-axis,
yes,
I am going to. So the efficiency is going to be using energy less or wavelength higher. Here or not?
Sir,
if I want to use
actually this question.
Yes, please. Ask the question.
You shown that question mark, no? You shown that.
Yeah, it is there.
Is there any? Yeah. Yes, I am seeing, sir, this one. My question
okay.
is that means do we need a dye that can absorb light in visible region, and that we can do also.
You can do that, but the efficiency will not be more than 10%.
100%.
That is not a good. You can only shift in the x-axis, but y-axis you cannot shift. If you want to shift in the y-axis also, you have to modulate the conduction band edge. You are not modulating when you use the dye. You are not modulating the conduction band edge. You are only transferring the electron from the dye to the conduction band edge. Clear?
Okay. Yes, sir. Clear. Thank you.
Any other question? Because many people are looking at us in various ways. I don't want to tell you about it. Even the Western world was asking me, why are you doing all these things when the subject itself is so fluid? But I hope I have not made it as fluid as possible. Any other questions? Manjunathan, any questions?
Actually, I have one question, sir. In the last slide, you mentioned that we have to get a material with a single phase of 001 plane.
No, I didn't say that. I only said, is it good?
Okay.
That is the wrong message. I said, okay. Because if that is the problem with the titanium dioxide, whatever you do with titanium dioxide, you will prepare it either 001 or 010. That is all the phase that will come. And we know very well one of them is active, one of them is not active.
Non-active.
So therefore you will make as many active as many inactive sites when you synthesize. Because both of them have got equal probability.
Okay, sir. Is it possible to synthesize a material with only one phase without
any? It's possible to synthesize, but it is possible. But it will not be economical. So
okay,
we have to also think economical also.
Yes, sir.
And the yield will be very, very less if you were to synthesize in only one phase.
Yield will be very less. Okay, sir.
My, if you ask me, I would say we have to forget titanium dioxide. But I don't think any one of us will like that statement. But still, that is what it is. Any other questions? Prakriti, after a long time, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Any questions?
Same question, Manjunath asked. Same question.
At least this time you could listen directly.
Yeah, directly I can.
Very good. So you see, this is the first attempt. So there will be some hiccups, but when we go above, in the future we'll be able to resolve all of them. But anyway, the material was available in YouTube, so you could at the YouTube and at your leisure.
Okay. Sir, why can't that 0011 is already, you told it not economical.
Why?
No, sir, you said that titanium dioxide we can synthesize 001 plane. It is not economical, you said.
That is because it is a very slow crystallization phenomenon. So if the crystallization is very slow, the yield also will be very low.
Why can't we other planes are...
You can do only by you adding some impurity. The moment you are adding impurity, see, these are all the sensitization, okay? If you are lazy, if I am lazy, you can come and ask questions, I may act, that is all. So sensitization is possible, but when we sensitize it, as I told you, we are not going to alter the band gap or the conduction bandage. We are going to alter only the kind of valence bandage.
Okay.
So therefore, synthesizing TiO2 by adding some impurities and other things is not going to be of any great use. Please don't get discouraged, because I have to tell you the truth of the science. What is the use? Just like everybody, I am going on repeating like a parrot, titanium dioxide is the best photocatalyst and all that. I don't want to say that. Because having demonstrated what is the problem, I must be honest to myself. Correct or not? Okay, any other questions?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So you mentioned the importance of altering the conduction bands, right? So what can be done for altering the conduction band of the semiconductor? If we are speaking about some alteration in titanium dioxide, whatever, if we dock with any other metal or any other impurities, everything what we are doing will be the alteration of the valence band only, right?
Yes.
Is there
I showed all the pictures. I showed all the pictures.
So, how can you give an idea, or how can we alter the conduction?
That is, if I tell you, that is the see the. I will answer this question. I have no problem to answer this question, but you young minds should come with a new. I may not be. I'm also a old man. Therefore, I will also think in the older fashion. There may be some innovative way of doing this. Okay, you have to think innovatively there.
Sir, if we modify, you showed an example of platinum and titanium dioxide.
That is only okay. That is because values were there available to me to explain that. But platinum is not a good solution. Okay, tell me what is the question.
Sir, I was thinking that if platinum is a good reducer, we can use it for reduction.
No. Metal is not a good solution. Metallizing a semiconductor is not a solution, because it still does not alter the conduction band.
Okay. So even though we dock with some metal, it will alter the valence band only.
Yeah. It will not. Otherwise, it will give some energy levels in between the conduction band and valence band. That is what I have shown in the platinum case. But that is not there. I have to now look for. Yeah, I have already talked about it. Some kind of a substitution in the A position or B position. The cationic positions I must be able to alter. So therefore, it is no longer, for example, sodium tantalate, I showed it to you. That is not a good choice. So I should take sodium, even if I take sodium tantalate, I must be able to put a mixed valence state of tantalum and another ion there. So therefore we have to look at other options rather than this. Even perovskites are not good, because perovskites, once again, the B cation is a single cation. Strontium titanate is a perovskite. But there is no use, because titanium is still the 3D level of titanium only is the conduction band. That is why we have to now think totally differently from the known mixed materials.
Okay. Even sensitization is also not good enough.
No, sensitization only. The platinum is also sensitizing only.
Okay.
I have sensitized it from the electron from the semiconductor to platinum. What you are saying is, I will take the sensitize it from the dye to the titanium dioxide. Still, the conduction band is the same. If the conduction band is the same, CO2 reduction will be difficult. The drawing that I have drawn, shown by the pencil, you must keep that drawing with you and think about it. After 1 month, when we are having another course, we will ask this question again. We'll see what is the fruit of this in your minds. So now all of you must respond. If you want another course, when we will start? You want immediately to start, or you want a small vacation, or what do you want? Everything must be very clearly told to us. Anybody want to comment now? The Bombay people, do they want another course? There are three or four of you from Bombay.
Yes, sir.
Why?
We are from same lab. Sir, okay. Actually,
doesn't matter for me. It is only demography or topography only. Okay, doesn't matter. I know very well. You have very many groups there. Okay. Anyway, anybody wants to comment? We want another course or another topic, but it will be only on research. It will not be a mundane topic of classroom teaching. And on the overall, Manjunathan, do you tell me what is your opinion overall? Hello? Are you there or not? Okay, with the Bangalore people, Venkatesa. Or from the Cochin or Bombay people. Let me ask Priyanka. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, what are you doing in ICT, I hope, correct?
Yes, sir. I'm doing PhD in green technology.
PhD in?
Green technology.
With whom? Who is your mentor?
Dr. Yash Ankaling. I'm in the same lab with the Yogesh and Bala Sahib.
Okay. I saw two of you are from green technology, correct or not?
Yes, Yogesh and me.
Okay, you ask one question. How did you come to know this course? Because you didn't attend our orientation program.
From Balu only.
Okay.
What's there?
Okay, tell me whether we want the course, we will keep it.